Philippine Health Department, or DOH, on Friday, March 5, reports 52 additional cases of the South African variant of COVID-19, bringing the total number of the variant's cases up to 58. The DOH also reports 31 new cases of the United Kingdom variant of COVID-19. Total number of UK variant cases goes up to 118. Experts say the South African and UK variants are more infectious than the original version of COVID-19 and may have an impact on vaccine efficacy. Meanwhile, the Philippines' daily positivity rate hits 9.16% Wednesday, March 3. It is the highest rate recorded since September 18, 2020, when the country logged 9.23%. The positivity rate is the percentage of all COVID-19 test results that are actually positive. On vaccine updates, 487,200 doses of AstraZeneca and Oxford University's COVID-19 vaccines arrive in the Philippines Thursday night, March 4. President Rodrigo Duterte welcomes the shipment in a ceremony at Villamor Air Base, but not without a two-hour delay. Duterte arrives 2 hours late at 9:30 p.m. From the airport, the vaccines are brought to a warehouse of logistics company, Metropack Logistics, in Marikina City. The government's pandemic task force says the distribution of vaccines throughout the Philippines will immediately commence after repackaging. Duterte also says China will donate 400,000 more doses of a COVID-19 vaccine. He does not mention the brand and the expected date of arrival. The Philippines' inflation rate spikes to 4.7% in February 2021, the highest since the 4.4% recorded in January 2019. It is also the fifth straight monthly increase and follows the 4.2% inflation rate in January 2021. National statistician Dennis Mapa on Friday, March 5, says the uptick is mainly caused by the increase in meat prices. President Rodrigo Duterte previously imposed a 60-day price ceiling on pork and chicken prices starting February, but it prompted vendors to stop selling instead. Meantime, Duterte says he will reopen the economy if most Filipinos will be vaccinated. Duterte also earlier said he would allow face-to-face classes and declare a nationwide lifting of major quarantine restrictions if the country has a stock of 2 million vaccine doses. Duterte says education officials and his economic team are pestering him about lifting restrictions and further opening up the economy. Filipino chess prodigy Wesley So officially becomes an American citizen, snuffing out hopes of luring him back to the Philippines. In an announcement on its website, the U.S. Chess Federation says So became a U.S. citizen on February 26. Born in Bacoor, Cavite, So decided to join the U.S. Chess Federation in 2014 after getting frustrated with Philippine sports politics. In an interview with his new national federation, So says this doesn't mean that he doesn't love the Philippines, but he did not have the connections needed to succeed in that culture. He says there is only one country where a nobody can make it, the USA. So, who is currently living in Minnesota, also says he wants to give back to a country that has been so good to him. The 27-year-old So stunned world number one Magnus Carlsen last February in the Opera Euro Rapid Chess Championship, just 3 months after also upsetting the Norwegian genius for the Skilling Open title. A Mandaluyong court issues a release order for detained journalist Lady Ann Salem and trade unionist Rodrigo Esparago. The issuance comes a month after presiding judge Monique Kisimbing Ignacio dismissed the charges of illegal possession of firearms and explosives against Salem and Esparago earlier in February. Despite the court's decision, the two remain detained because their prosecutors are blocking their release, saying the court's decision needs to be final. Salem, Esparago, and 5 other activists were arrested on December 10, 2020, during their celebration of International Human Rights Day. Korean pop sensation BTS wins the 2020 Global Recording Artist of the Year award from Recorded Music Industry Representative Body, IFPI. The 7-member group had a hugely successful 2020, becoming the first K-pop act to reach number 1 in the US Billboard Hot 100 Singles chart. The group also secured its first major Grammy nomination. BTS is also named Entertainer of the Year by Time Magazine. IFPI says the award takes account of an act's worldwide performance in digital and physical music formats during the year. American singer-songwriter Taylor Swift comes in second in the IFPI Global Artist Chart, while Canadian rapper Drake is third. Posts claiming Vice President Lenny Robredo got vaccinated without rolling up her sleeves are false. Some pro-administration bloggers posted a photo mocking Robredo for receiving a COVID-19 vaccine while wearing a long-sleeved blouse. Crisette Loretta Chu posts on Facebook, because Lenny Robredo doesn't and has never rolled up her sleeves for anything. Sasasot also posts the photo without mentioning Robredo. Her caption reads, I know this is symbolic. Please raise the sleeve so the act is more believable. How to make a scene 101. Her followers assume she's referring to Robredo, a common subject of her attacks. The woman in the picture is Dr. Flor Delisa Grana, a pediatric surgeon. Robredo calls out the false claim on her Facebook account. Grana then shares Robredo's post on her personal account and says, "My blouse's sleeves have holes. Please report those spreading fake news." Grana is among the 1,500 healthcare workers who received the Sinovac vaccine in Marikina City on Tuesday, March 2.